Hey there, my name's Logan. I'm a technical instructor here at DBT Labs, and I'm gonna be walking you through how to connect your DBT project to your Databricks platform, as well as to your repository. Today we'll be using GitHub for our repository, but you may be using something a little bit different. You'll notice before I start rolling into getting my project set up, I have a couple different tabs up here. First, DBT Cloud, obviously. The second being Databricks. Inside of Databricks, I'm going to get a little bit of information about my connection details. So you're going to want to make sure you have that pulled up, as well as my GitHub repository. This is the repository that me and my organization have already agreed on using. And this is where I'll be tying all of my DBT Cloud code back to. So I have these tabs open just to make sure that I can jump in and check that things are working as expected. Let's get started with this project setup. Once you get in, the first thing you're going to be asked to do is to name your project. Now, this is an exciting aspect, right? This is what you're going to be seeing the entire time you're working inside of DBT Cloud. So you want to make sure that you're picking a name that makes sense to you and to your organization. This name for your project is where all of your code, all of your models are ideally going to be living. So you want to make sure that it's something that makes sense. Perhaps it's your organization's name. Perhaps you just want to stick with analytics. Today, I'm going to be going with DBT Databricks tutorial. That makes sense for me, and that's what we're going to be using. Once I click continue, you'll notice up here in the top right, I have my account information, Logan Cochran Sandbox, and then my DBT Databricks tutorial. This is my project name. This is the name that we just agreed upon here, and you'll see that it's populating inside of DBT. Once I have a name, we're going to get kicked down to this choose a warehouse option. Now you can see our big connectors that we have, Snowflake, Postgres, SQL, BigQuery, Redshift, and finally Databricks. If you look just a little bit below, you'll notice there's an Apache Spark connector as well. These do very similar things, these being Apache Spark and Databricks. But what I want to encourage you to do is to use the Databricks connector. The Databricks connector is going to provide us with a little bit more functionality inside of Databricks. And when we build up that connection between DBT Cloud and Databricks itself. So we've selected Databricks and we're going to go ahead and click next. The next aspect of setting things up is configuring our environment. So you'll see the warehouse we're using is Databricks. If you want to change the name, you're welcome to. I'm just going to keep it as Databricks. Just below the warehouse information, you'll see some more info about the adapter. Keep in mind up here, when we chose our warehouse, we chose Databricks, not Apache Spark. Down here in configure environment, we're going to be asked to confirm that option, right? We have the Databricks adapter and we have the Spark adapter. If you wanted a little more information about the difference between the two, you'll notice that the DBT Spark adapter does not support the Databricks Unity catalog. And that's the big functionality that we want to make sure we're getting the most out of here. I'm going to keep Databricks selected because that's what I want. I want to be able to use that Unity catalog. I want to be able to specify where things are building inside of Databricks. Down below, I have some setting information. DBT Cloud is always going to be connecting from these IPs. So it may be necessary for you and your organization inside of Databricks to whitelist these IPs to make sure that traffic is allowed coming in from DBT Cloud. It's going to be asking us for both the server hostname and the HTTP path. Now, these are our clusters or SQL warehouses that we'll be using, keeping in mind that this is simply our computational power inside of Databricks. I alluded earlier, we're gonna be needing to hop into Databricks, and this is where that's gonna be happening. To gather the server hostname and HTTP path, we're gonna hop back into Databricks SQL. A couple things to keep in mind. Here, I'm inside of the SQL branch, and I'm gonna click on SQL warehouses. Once I open this up, you can see all the warehouses that me and my organization have built to be able to utilize Databricks. The specific warehouse I'm going to be using is DBT Training Demo. But again, this is where you'll be able to choose whichever computational warehouse you want. Once I click into DBT Training Demo, we can see an overview of this warehouse. But next, you'll see these connection details. Connection details is what we've come for. We want this server hostname and we want this HTTP path. I'm going to copy both. So let's copy this and drop it into my server hostname and my HTTP path. I'm going to copy here and we're going to drop in here. The next optional setting we have is for catalog. Keeping in mind that catalog is Databricks' version of databases, and this says optional, right? If I do not indicate a catalog into which I want to build, what dbt is actually going to do, let's hop into our data here in Databricks, and we can see all of my catalogs listed here. If you don't indicate into which catalog you want it to build, dbt is going to default build into the Hive metastore, right? And again, this is the difference between our Spark connector and our Databricks connector. Using Databricks connector, we can choose a catalog that we want. Using the Spark connector, it's only going to build into the Hive metastore. So if you wanted to diversify where you're building, that's where that Databricks connector is coming into play. And I actually do. I'm going to use this training test catalog to build into. So training underscore test is the catalog I'm going to put right here. Again, this is totally optional to you. If you're comfortable and you want things built into Hive Metastore, you can leave this blank, in which case it will default there. If you want to choose a catalog to build, then that's where you're going to indicate that here. The last aspect for our connection details are these development credentials. Now, keep in mind, these are our personal development credentials for the data platform we're using, right? So this has nothing to do with dbt Cloud. This is giving dbt Cloud access to Databricks. So this is going to be a personalized token coming straight from Databricks. And to get that, I'm going to navigate once again back to Databricks. And I'm going to go up here into the top right. You can see my username information. And if I click the dropdown, I have my user settings. Once I click into this, we can see query snippets, but we can also see personal access tokens. If I click into this, I'm going to be offered to generate a new token. This token, you can put whatever you want. This is for my dbt Cloud access. And there's a lifetime of your token. This is going to be kind of determined by you and your organization, but Databricks is going to default it to 90 days. I'm going to drop it down to 10 days because I'm not going to need it for very long. I'm simply using it for this tutorial. Once I generate it, you can see here is my token. I'm going to copy this token and I'm going to bring it back to dbt Cloud and drop it in here. Databricks is telling me to make sure that I copy it because I won't be able to see it again. I click OK and you can see the token exists, but I no longer have access to that specific token. If you forget to copy it or your token expires, you can always come back here and simply generate a new token for access and you'll drop it here into your token in dbt Cloud. The schema is again, a field that we can change. It's going to default to dbt plus my username, which is L. Cochran, first initial last name. But you can change this to whatever you want. This schema is going to be building inside of this catalog. All right. So currently, if we navigate back to Databricks, click on our data, we can see this training test has a few schemas inside of it already. We have default and we have information schema. Once I start utilizing dbt Cloud, it's going to build a new schema, dbtl Cochran, excuse me, where all of my tables and views will be built. Once that's done, I'm going to go ahead and test the connection. We're going to keep our fingers crossed that everything works. We're setting things up, we're testing it, and dbt Cloud will let us know once that connection is tested. All righty, we're back. My connection has been tested, and we can see complete. Your test completed successfully, you're good to go. Awesome. I'm going to click next, and it's going to bring me into the next aspect of connecting my dbt project, which is setting up a repo. We've worked inside of Databricks now, and now we're going to turn our attention over to GitHub. We have an option to select a repository here. I'm using GitHub, so that's what I'm going to be choosing. And then you can see that I'm connecting to my profile. I'm already connected. So I can choose the repository that I want, which is Databricks-demo, which we can see here. I'm going to click on Databricks demo. And I am going to work on connecting here. Once that's connected, I'm going to get this notification that my project is ready. So I can do a couple things. I can use a get started tutorial, but I'm actually going to start developing inside of the IDE. When you click this, dbt is going to take a moment to connect to your repo, connect to your warehouse, make sure that everything that it's presenting you here inside of dbt Cloud is what it should be. So it may take a moment to load everything, but once it does, we should be able to see the beginnings of a dbt cloud project. All right, so dbt is connected. And if we see over here in this file explorer, not a lot going on, right? I just have a Databricks demo and only a README markdown file. Yours may look a little bit different, but you'll notice here in my version control and Git integration, I have this option to initialize my dbt project. Before you do anything, you're always going to want to initialize the dbt project. Now, this is a one and done thing. I've set up my project. I've connected to Databricks. I've connected to GitHub. I'm going to initialize my project, and anybody else who comes in will never have to do this step again. This is simply me asking dbt, hey, set up my dbt project with all the necessary pieces that I need to get started. You can see that's pretty quick, and we can see inside of my version control everything that was added, as well as inside of my file explorer, all of the different files that we added here. Most of these folders are going to be empty, but you will see inside of the models, there's an example with a couple sample models for dbt. I'm going to go ahead and commit and push this, and we are going to say initial commit, and I'm going to commit and push. This is setting up my main branch inside of GitHub with all the necessary files that I need, so anybody else who comes into my project can begin accessing and collaborating with me. You'll notice here inside of this version control, it tells me that I'm on the main branch, which is read-only. I no longer can access any edits on these, but I can simply look at what exists inside of my project. Let's do a quick jump over here into GitHub and see what happens. If we come into GitHub and we refresh, we can see all of these files now exist, right? My GitHub repository was initially empty. And now after I've initialized my project, we can see the same folders exist here that exist inside of my dbt cloud project. Now, there are a couple other tests I want to do just to make sure that everything's working. So I'm going to create a branch. I'm going to call this demo branch. Naming conventions are something that you and your organization will want to agree upon, but demo branch works just fine for me right now. Once I submit that, essentially what dbt is going to do is it's going to work with GitHub to create my own version of everything that exists. Right now, I can go in and I can begin editing things and making changes, collaborating with my peers. To get things started, I'm going to do a dbt run. At this point, it's important to remind you that dbt is not housing data for us. It's simply connecting to our data platform, which in this case is Databricks, and it's running queries against that. It's helping Databricks build different views and tables out and make sure that these new models that I've built inside of dbt cloud also exist inside of my data platform. When I do dbt run, it's essentially taking the code that I've compiled inside of cloud and sending it over to Databricks to ensure that these views are built as well. One thing to keep in mind when we're connecting to Databricks is the computational warehouses that exist inside of Databricks do need to be spun up. So when I do a dbt run, that first one is typically going to take a little bit longer than the subsequent runs that I have, right? Because I have to make sure that my computational warehouse is awake and is running. Once I've done dbt run, we can see this is successful. I've built out two models, my first dbt model and my second dbt model. I want to circle back to finalize all of this example. Going back into Databricks, we can see now inside of this training test catalog, there's a new schema, dbtl Cochrane. This is the schema that I identified inside of my specific developer credentials. Keep in mind that everyone inside of your team will have their own unique schema that they're building to. If I look inside of the schema, dbtl Cochrane, I can identify my first dbt model along with my second dbt model. That command dbt run is what sent these out here to be built inside of my specific schema. And now you can see the connection between dbt cloud connecting to GitHub, which houses all of my code, dbt run, pushing all of that code and doing the builds inside of my data platform, which is Databricks. So my project is set up. It's ready to go, and I can begin developing.